The fish that couldn't climb trees. Simon the fish splished and splashed and dashed about the river weeds. He whizzed and whooshed and twisted through the water round the sticks and reeds. He swam at speed this way and that, jumped from the water with a spin. He felt the air against his scales, then grinned a grin and plopped back in.
"Ay, fish, ay, fish,"
he heard as he was flying through the morning air. He stopped and looked towards the bank and saw a squirrel standing there.
"Hey, fish, I see you swim quite well,"
he sneered.
"You're not as good as me. I'll bet that you're no good on land. I'll bet that you can't climb a tree."
With that, he shot straight up a tree and stood there with a splendid stance, stared down at Simon from the top and danced a little squirrel dance. Simon struggled through the shallow waters by the river bank, and as he flopped across the mud, his little fishy heart it sank. As hard as he could flap his fins, as hard as he could thrash his tail, as hard as he could push himself, he knew that he was bound to fail. He couldn't make it through the mud, the twigs and all the fallen leaves. He couldn't make it to the trees, no, he could only gasp and wheeze.
"Ha ha," laughed Squirrel, "you're no good. You shouldn't try, you shouldn't oughta. Stay off my land and out my trees. You're like a fishy out of water."
Simon sank back to the depths, right down to hug the riverbed. So sad that he could not climb trees, he shrugged his fins and shook his head. "How I wish I could climb trees," he sighed and cried. He felt depleted. Simon slinked behind a rock. He felt so sad he was defeated. Squirrel danced upon his branch, guffawing, giggling and hooting. Then he spluttered and he coughed. He tripped and slipped and lost his footing. Squirrel screamed, and as he fell, he flapped his arms to no avail. He fell into the stream below, a massive splash. He whooped and wailed. He burbled and he babbled, bubbles bursting as he paddled. And the current pulled him under as he splished and splashed and scrabbled. Squirrel thought,
"Now this is it. I cannot swim, I'm bound to drown."
He grumbled and he tumbled through the water as it dragged him down. But then came Simon, swimming fast.
"At last," thought Squirrel, "help is here."
And Simon pulled him through the water, tugging Squirrel's fluffy ear. Squirrel gasped the morning air. Clever Simon pushed and heaved. Then out they flopped onto the bank and squelched into the muddy leaves. Squirrel panted.
"Thank you, fish. That was so very good of you to fish me from the water after I behaved like such a fool."
"That's all right," said Simon Fish. "You acted like a silly clown, but that's no reason not to help. I couldn't sit and watch you drown." Next day, the squirrel came with friends. He pointed,
"Everyone, that's him. He's the fish that saved my life. Oh, Simon, teach us how to swim."
So Simon spent the morning teaching squirrels how to doggy paddle, then the breaststroke and front crawl, until they were quite tired, bedraggled. Now, if any danced on branches, lost their footing and fell in, they could swim back to the bank and climb back up their tree again. To give their thanks, some carried Simon to an overhanging branch and watched him dive into the water as others sat and had their lunch. They clapped and cheered as Simon span so deftly through the air, and then, on Wednesdays, there's a competition. They watch and mark him out of 10